Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of GCC compiler on a Windows operating system. And I am also going to show you how to use that latest version of GCC compiler for writing C programs. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you will be learning a lot of new things. And if you are still facing any issues in middle, you can always ask me on comment sections. And I am also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there and you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I am definitely going to help you. So now to install the latest version of GCC compiler, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to search over here GCC download for Windows. So just simply click on that. So that will show you the sourceforge.net link. So you need to go to this GCC-win64 download, and that's going to redirect to the sourceforge.net. Here, if you see, we have under project activity, we have all these different releases, right? So this is the latest one, version 14.2.0. If you want to download some older version, so that also you can do. So you need to go with all these different links. You can also go to files, and you can have a look on all these different versions also, right? So starting from version 7, you can see that those are also available. I'm going to download the latest one, so I'm going to click on this, and I'm going to click on this download button, and it's going to start downloading our GCC compiler. And you can see that our GCC compiler is rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser, I'll go to my download directory, and you can see that our GCC compiler version 14.2.0 is already downloaded over here. So all you need to do is now just right click and click on extract all. So just simply click on extract. So that's going to start extracting our GCC compiler over here. It's a little big file, about 1.2 gigabyte of extraction going to happen. So you know, let's wait for some time, and by the time it get extract, I request you to subscribe your channel Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I'm posting a lot of coding related videos, so do check out our channel Geeky Syntax, and also don't forget to subscribe. And also I'm posting a lot of videos on WordPress, so if you're interested, you can also watch this entire playlist. So some videos are 1 hour, some videos are 1 hour 30 minute video, some videos are in series, so you can watch all these different videos on our playlist. I can guarantee if you watch this playlist, you'll be definitely going to learn a lot of new things about WordPress, and these are completely free. Alright, so yeah. So yeah, let's wait for some time. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see that our GCC compiler is rightly extracted. So you can close this folder. So here is our extracted folder. So now all you need to do is, you need to just simply right click and you need to go to the show more options and you need to click on rename. So you want to rename this folder to little shorter. So we're going to remove this no debug thing, and we're going to keep only GCC and then a version name. And then you need to right click this folder and cut this folder and go to your C drive and just simply right click and paste that folder over here. So our GCC version 14.2 folder is rightly downloaded, extracted, and also pasted on our C drive. Now you need to set your environment path. So just simply go inside this folder, go to bin folder, and now to select this address bar and right click and copy this path. And now just simply go to search and just simply type environ. So that will show you this edit the system environment variables. Just simply click on that. That will open the system properties window. So go to environment variables. So that will open this environment variable window. Here you need to just simply click on path and click on edit. So that will open this edit the environment variable window. Here you need to just simply click on new and right click and paste that latest version of GCC compiler that you have downloaded and extracted and pasted on C drive folder. So that bin folder path is what you need to paste it over here. And then just simply click on OK. Then again OK. And then again OK. And now you can close this directory as well. And now to verify whether GCC compiler is actually installed on your system or not, just simply go to search and type cmd. So that will show you this command prompt over here. So just simply go to your command prompt and just simply type over here GCC space dash dash version and just simply hit enter. So that's going to show you this GCC version 14.2.0. So that's the version that I have installed. So that is what it is showing over here. If you are getting some different message, something like GCC is not recognized as an internal or an external command. So all that basically mean is your GCC is not installed properly on your system. So I recommend you to watch this video all over again, set the environment path properly that I have showed you. Just follow all the steps properly, alright. So if you are doing everything properly, it should be showing this message. And if you get this message, then all that basically means is your GCC compiler is directly installed. And now you are good to start your programming journey on C and C++ programming. So I'm going to show you that only now. So I'll just create a new folder and I'm going to name this folder as C Programs. I'll just simply go inside that folder and I'm going to create a text document. So new and click on text document. So let's give the file name as Hello World and I'm going to change this .txt extension with .c. Hit enter. Do you want to change the file name extension? Yes. And it is rightly changed. So you have a C source file now. So you need to change this. If you are unable to see this type of file name extension, then all that you need to do is you need to go to view and hover over show, and then you need to enable this file name extensions. See, we have a tick mark icon. So all that basically means is it's going to show this type of file name extensions. So I have changed this to .txt to .c. So that's what you need to do. Now just write a simple hello world program on C. And I'm going to write a simple hello world program. So hash include stdio.h int main, open the parenthesis, close that parenthesis, and just simply do printf hello world. So hello world, close that semicolon, and simply return something. So something like return 0. So it is an int main method, so it expects something to be returned. So we are returning 0. So our program should be working fine. Just go to file and save this file. And just simply go back to your C program folder, just select this address bar and just simply type cmd, hit enter. So that's going to open your command prompt right at this location. You can see it's rightly opened over here, right? So now to compile and run this file, all you need to do is you need to just simply type gcc and then name of your file, which is hello world.c. So you need to type that exact thing, hello world.c, and simply hit enter. So that's going to immediately generate a file called a.exe. So you can see a file getting generated over here, right? So all that basically means is your program is compiled successfully and with no errors. So it has generated a a.exe file. So now to run this file a.exe, you need to just simply type over here a, that is basically name of our exe a. Just type that a and hit enter, and there you go. Can get that output coming over here, hello world. So whatever you have written, so that exact output should be coming on your console. All right and in this way you can start working on your C or C++ programming journey using latest version of GCC compiler, that is version 14.2.0. all right so that's basically all about this video, friends. Don't forget to watch this playlist and also our other different WordPress videos, and also don't forget to subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel as well. And lastly, special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.